Units of signal energy depends on the unit of the signal. Yeah, that is fine. And now power. So the thing what you have to remember from here is this formula. If x of t is my signal, then I have to take the absolute value and I have to square it and the integral from minus infinity to infinity. Some signals have finite signal energy. In that case, it is more convenient to deal with average power. So if you see here we are taking minus infinity to infinity. However, when we are taking the power, the limits has been changed to minus t by 2 to t by 2. Why? Anyone? For power signals, power is between 0 and infinity, but e equal to infinity. But in this particular case, energy signal, a signal of finite energy is called, whenever you are saying that energy signal, energy of a signal, for that it should be always finite. Okay, when I am saying it is a power signal, then power of that particular signal, if it is finite, then we call it a power signal. It is irrespective of the energy. Okay, whereas here, if you see, the power is zero, wherever here energy is infinite. So the average power of the signal is given by label. We will see some numerical problems to see more, analytics about this energy and power signal. For a periodic signal, the average signal power is given like this. So what is the difference here? The difference here is minus t by 2. The limits has been changed to only t. And in this way, you can periodic signal, you can calculate. And where t is the periodicity or the period of any signal. Okay. Periodic signals are generally power signals. And in the discrete case, we can see that the energy, as soon as if you say a discrete case, only this formula, wherever this integral is there, it is going to be replaced with the summation sign. Okay, so why these discrete things are more important, or because in some cases calculating the integrals will be very difficult for very large systems. However, calculations of the summations will be easy. This sample time, this n is very, very small, then my continuous signals and the discrete signals will look alike. It will not be same, but it will be look alike. That means if the samples between two, if the sampling rate is very high, or if it is the t, delta t is very small, then what I can say that then my continuous signal and the discrete signal will look the same. And this is similarly the formula for the average power signal. You can see that 1 by 2n, when n tends to infinity, small n equal to minus n to n minus 1. And when I say that the average signal, then it becomes 1 by n sigma n equal to this square, this braces in between the brackets, this n. Means the sum over any set of consecutives and exactly n is the length. We'll see what is this. So we'll try to solve the problems now. I think this is very small. So what we are trying to do here is, okay, I'm saying that x of t is my signal. What is the signal? How it will look like? What do you mean by u of t? U of t is nothing but a step signal. Step signal is only defined for t is greater than or equal to 0. If t is less than 0, then this particular u of t will become 0, and hence this x of t will become 0. So that's what here it has been represented. X of t equal to e to the power of minus t for t is greater than 0. For t is greater than 0, this u of t will be 1. Otherwise, this u of t will be 0. Okay. Then what I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to evaluate the integral from minus t to t x of t square. What is this particular thing? What is this formula? If you see, so which formula we are trying to calculate now? What we are looking into now? These are some of the formulas what we discussed. We discussed only two different formulas. One is for the energy and another for the power. So now if you see this one, minus t to t, modulus of x of t whole square, x of t square. So x of t is my signal. If I am replacing it e to the power of minus 2t whole square, and then why this minus p to t has been changed to 0 to t? This particular quantity is only defined here. So that's why it has become 0 to t. Okay. If I substitute, if I keep on going like this, and if I take the integral and if I substitute, then it will become something like this. Then upper limit and lower limit, if I substitute, then it will, because this minus and minus e to the power is 1, then this minus and this, you know, this minus will cancel out. So that will become 1 by 4 minus e to the power minus 4 by t. So this is the normal expression when I want to calculate minus t to t. Now we'll see if you want to calculate the energy of the signal. So if you want to calculate the energy of the signal, this is the formula what we have seen. Limit t tends to infinity minus t to t x of t whole square. So why we have calculated this x of t whole square into dt is just I will substitute here. So only the thing is, what I'll be doing here is, I'll just saying that t tends to infinity. Okay. T tends to infinity, if I write like this, 1 by 4 minus, what is e to the power of minus infinity?
0.
Why it is 0? 0, sir. Because e to the power minus infinity means 1 by e to the power of infinity. What is e to the power of 1? What is e value? So e value, e square, e cube, e to the power 4 as the exponent of e value, if it is keep on increasing, since it is in the denominator because of minus infinity, so if you keep on increasing, then what is going to happen is this denominator will become so large that the whole quantity will become approximately equal to 0. That's what is happening here. Okay. So now I will calculate the power of a signal. So this is the formula. Limit t tends to infinity, 1 by 2t minus t to t x of t whole square. So now, if I use the same formula here, and already this is already been evaluated. The same formula what we have evaluated here, I'll be using for both energy and the power. So now I can say that the power of the signal is 0 wherever the energy is 1 by 4. This is quite obvious. Okay, this is one particular calculate, if a signal is given. So now what you have to do here is, all of you please write down two different problems you have to do. The first one is, okay, now what you have to do here is, you have to find the energy and power of sine 2t, cosine of 2t, the combination of sine and cosine, 20t, t, and the constant 30. So this will be assignment for today's class, not the assignment, you have to do it now. Energy and power. For the energy, you have to use this formula, whatever you are seeing here. And for power, you have to use this particular formula. How much time it will take for you to do for these 5 cases? Okay, this you can do it. So now this is about the classification of the signals. When it comes to the classification of the systems, there will be various aspects one has to consider. The difference between the systems and signals is, system is basically a hardware component, or it could be physical component. Like it could be made up, if it is in filters, it could be made up of RLC. If it is a digital filter, then some digital processor is required, and some kind of physical realization. In general, you can see the systems, but you cannot see the signals. You cannot see the signals. Only you have to, imagine about the signal. However, you can feel the signals. For example, if you want to feel the signal, just put your hand in the, electrical socket, then you will feel. You can see whether it is really sinusoidal or not. If it is a DC or, if you use the high power batteries, if you try to just short circuit to your hand and try to feel how you are, what is your experience? If you want to experience some sinusoidal kind of experience, just try to put your hands in the electrical socket and see the you can feel whether it is it is pulsating signal or not. Okay, so that's what I'm seeing. I'm saying that signals can only be you cannot see the signals, whereas you can see the systems. And signals, generally the power and energy are the two main components of the signals what one has to analyze. So if, let us assume two numbers are given to you, 5 and 10. You can tell something about, you can tell something about that particular magnitude of, if it is 5 or 10. If I say that, which one is the greater one? Which one is the larger number? Then you can obviously say that 10, because 10 is greater than 5. However, if I give you some random two different random signals, and if I ask you to conclude something about the signals, which one is more, powerful or so on. So what you have to do is, if you come up with this particular formula, you can, what we have seen is, generally you will be, you will get only single value for energy or for the power. So based upon that, I can say that, okay, this energy, this signal has more energy or it has more power, and hence I will use this particular signal for particular analysis. Okay. So for example, if you want to compare two different signals, random signals, the one such metric is finding the energy of the signal or finding the power of the signal. So that is highly possible through the analysis, whatever we are doing. Because if it is a scalar, that means single numbers, then obviously you can see the magnitude. But you cannot see the magnitude of a signal, random signal, two different signals. Because for some time, for some time interval, the signal might have very large positive value, and for another time instant it will be negative value, and for some other time instant it is zero, and so on. If it is only perfectly sinusoid signal, if both of them are the sinusoid signals, then okay, by seeing the magnitude, we can say that which one have the more strength than as comparative to the other one. That is possible. However, if the signals are completely random, you don't know how it is varying, and if you want to come up with a single number to say which signal has more, power or energy, then this formula can be used. Okay. So now my assignment here is, this is the assignment.